Hello, welcome to the session on multiplexing. This is Dayanand Patil, a faculty member of Computer Science and Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. At the end of this session, you will be able to understand multiplexing or channelization in wireless communication. What is multiplexing? It is multiple access method in which the available bandwidth of link is shared in a time, frequency or through code. That is, the available spectrum is divided into the different channels. The different channels can be used by the different stations with the different characteristics like time, frequency or through code assigned with each station transmitting the data on the spectrum. Multiplexing is a technique in which multiple simultaneous analog or digital signals are transmitted across a single data link. When multiple senders try to send over a single medium, a device called multiplexer is used at the sender side that the physical channel and allocates one to each. That the available spectrum is divided and the divided physical channels are allocated to the each stations. On the other end of the communication, at the receiver side, the demultiplexer that receives data from a single medium identifies each and sends to the different receivers. The multiplexer will divide the channel and allocates to each station, and the demultiplexer will receive the data from different stations or that transmitted on the single medium and identified and sends to the appropriate stations. The multiplexing techniques. There are four basic multiplexing techniques: FDMEA, TDM, CDM, SDM, or it is also called as FDMEA, TDMEA, CDMEA, SDME. That FDM stands for frequency division multiplexing. Sometimes it is referred as frequency division multiple access. Similarly, for time division multiplexing or time division multiple access, these are the four techniques used for the multiplexing or channelization. The first one is the frequency division multiplexing or FDM. In FDM, available bandwidth is divided into frequency bands. Each station is allocated a band to the send its data, and it belongs to the station all the time. Okay, that available spectrum or the entire bandwidth is divided into the different channels. That each channel is assigned to a different stations. That station can independently use that particular channel or that particular channel at all the time. This is the best example is the radio stations. Okay, that each station is assigned with some frequency. At that frequency, that particular station will broadcast the programs. FDM is used because of the fact that number of frequency band can work simultaneously without any time constraint. If we are dividing the frequency and assigning channel to the different stations, all the stations can simultaneously work without any time constraint. At any time, those particular station can send the data on that frequency band at particular range at any time. The FDM can be used for radio stations in a particular region, as every radio station will have their own frequency and can work simultaneously without having any constraint of time. Already we are familiar with the radios and tuning the radio buttons. So this is the best example for frequency division multiplexing. Here we can visualize from this diagram. So that is, the available frequency is divided into the different frequency band. Assume that there are five stations: C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. So each station is assigned with that particular frequency range. At this frequency range, that station C1 can transmit the data, C2 can transmit the next range assigned. So these are the different, that available frequency is divided into the different ranges and assigned to the particular stations. So these stations can use at all time the available frequency. This is time division multiplexing. So in this method, the stations share the bandwidth of a channel in time. That each station is allocated a time slot during which it can send data. So instead of in the previous technique, we were divided the frequency and assigned to each station. But here, the entire frequency is assigned to each station during some time slot. At that time, only that station can use the entire available frequency. So there is no division in a frequency. During that particular time slot assigned for that station, only that station can send data over the medium. Okay, so here, the time is divided. In the previous one, the frequency was divided. In this technique, the time is divided. So during this time slot, the station C5 can transmit data on the frequency. So that is single channel. Any stations cannot send data during this time slot. The next time slot, okay, that C4 can send data during this time slot. So assuming that there are 5 stations, the time slot is divided between these 5 stations, and at that time, that particular station can use the entire frequency band. In TDMA, the bandwidth is just one channel, that is time shared between the different stations. In the previous one, the bandwidth was divided into different channels and shared by all the stations at a time at particular frequency. In this technique, the bandwidth is just a single channel, that frequency is single channel. That single channel, the entire channel can be used by the particular stations at different time slot assigned for those channels. Next one is the code division multiplexing. In the code division multiplexing, that each station will be assigned with a different code. Here the frequency is acting as a single channel, okay, that is the shared media. That media is acting as a single, but it is shared between the different stations. While any station is transmitting data on that particular media, it is transmitting data with its own code, but all can simultaneously transmit data on the single channel only. But each station is sending its data with its code that will be helpful at the receiver. So it is used in cell phone spectrum technology. So this is here we can visualize. At any time, all the stations can send data on the entire available frequency, but each of these stations will be having its own unique code. That code will be sent through its data on a single medium. You can see this in detail. So in the code division multiplexing, in this method, one channel carries all transmissions simultaneously, because there is a single channel, but all the stations are sending data on the single channel only with its own code. Each channel transmits data with different code. While transmitting the data, there are two properties to recognize proper code. These two properties helps the receiver to identify the data sent by that particular station. If codes are multiplied with each other, then the answer is 0. If codes are multiplied by itself, we'll get the 4. But here the 4 stands for the number of stations. If there are 5 stations, we can use it as 5. So it depends on. So these two properties helps to recognize the code at the receiver side. So assume that there are 4 stations, the station 1, station 2, station 3 and station 4. So each of these stations is having the code C1, C2, C3, C4. So according to the properties, if the codes are multiplied with each other, we'll get 0. The codes are multiplied by itself, we'll get 4. So assume that the station 1 sending the code C1, if the C1 is multiplied with each other, means other stations, will get 0. C1 into C2 equal to 0. C1 into C1 is 4, because if the codes are multiplied by itself, we'll get 4. So if C2 is multiplied with any other code, that is C4, it will get 0. If the C2 is multiplied by itself, we'll get the 4. It's it. The code is used in such a way that if codes are multiplied with each other, we'll get 0. If codes are multiplied by itself, we'll get 1. So we can form different cases. So these are some examples. So here we can see the example. The station 1 is transmitting a data D1 with a code C1, that C1 into D1. Okay, so that is the data is multiplied with a code and transmitted on a single media. The station 2 is sending a data 2 on the media, that is multiplied with a code C2. That C2 into D2 is transmitted. Similarly, for the other station, the station 3 is transmitting the data C3 into D3. The station 4 is transmitting C4 into D4. So all the station can send the data on a single channel simultaneously. So this is the users with a different code, user 1 with a code 1, user 2 with a code 2. So all can send on the single channel. So and this is received at the particular side. We can see the how it is recognized at the receiver side. So now how stations 2 can recognize the station 1? So by using the given properties, you think and write the answer for the given question. The question is how S2 can recognize the ST1 data transmitted on the media. Now you pause the video, think and write the answer. The answer is, if stations 2 wants to listen what ST1 says, okay, then that according to the properties, so first that all station can send data on the media. We can see from the previous slide, all the stations are sending on the single channel. Okay. So this is to receive the data from that particular channel, that S2 will multiply the code with 1, because the S2 want to listen what ST1 says. So it is going to multiply with the code of the station 1, that is C1. So that entire data transmitted on the channel and multiplied with a C1. Okay. So this is the simple mathematics. Okay. So now it is multiplied. Though C1 into C1 is 4, because we are multiplying itself, it is 4. It is multiplied with the other code. So that is 0 into D2, 0 into D3. So we are obtaining 4D1. So then S2 divides this obtained data by 4. So after dividing, we will get the D1. So D1 is received at the station 2. So this is the comparison between the different techniques. These are the references. Thank you.